Welcome back, motorsport simulation fans and simulation junkie. Throwing it back a little old school. We're going to NASCAR Thunder 2004 on the original Xbox. Now, this title actually came out on the PlayStation 1, the PlayStation 2, and PC. However, I prefer it on the original Xbox. One of the features I really enjoyed about this title was race as a NASCAR legend, once you unlock them, of course. And today what we are going to do is we are going to take the difficulty all the way up to hard, and we are going to go to a 25% race length. And that's right, today we are going to race as the number 3, Junior Johnson. That's right, Hall of Famer Junior Johnson. That is not Austin Dillon in that car, boys and girls. And we are going to race at an original NASCAR track. That's right, Daytona Beach. Now this track is half sand, half A1A pavement, 2 mile track. And what we're going to do today, we're going to try and start off in the middle of the pack and try to utilize our brain and a little pit strategy in order to get to the front and hopefully win. You never like to race a long race like this and not coming first when it's on YouTube. So sit back, enjoy, please comment, rate, and subscribe, and enjoy the great game of NASCAR Thunder 2004. Thanks, enjoy.
The NASCAR Winston Cup Series returns today to the sandy beach of Daytona, Florida, site of the original Daytona 500. Can you believe it, Barney? This ought to be one interesting race to see the new technology on the same old beach.
Well, I can't see how sand can possibly be good for these finely tuned engines, but we're sure going to have some fun finding out what happens. This is going to be one exciting race.
Jeff Gordon started out his career with a big splash, didn't he, Barney?
In 1992, Jeff Gordon became the first driver ever to win Rookie of the Year in both the Winston and the Busch Series.
Ken Schrader has earned over 20 pole positions during his NASCAR career.
Schrader's always been pretty good in qualifying, especially in the late 80s and early 90s. In 1993, he started 8 of 30 races from the front row, and when you're not working your way through traffic, a good finish is a lot easier.
Now let's take a look at the starting lineup. Starting out front are the STP Dodge and the Stacker 2 Dodge. Starting in row 2 will be the Lowe's Chevrolet and the Dodge Dealers UAW Dodge. In row 3 are the Sterling Marlin Dodge and the Home Depot Chevrolet. In row 4 are the Singular Wireless Chevrolet and the 64 car. Rounding out the top 10 starting spots are the GM Goodrich Chevrolet and the Fizer Ford. The 6th row has the 28 car and the Dodge Dealers UAW Dodge. In row 7 are the DuPont Chevrolet and the UPS Ford. Starting the race from row 8 are the 01 car and the Haviland Dodge. And in row 9 are the 16 car and the Rubbermaid Sharpie Ford. Starting in row 10 will be the UAW Delphi Chevrolet and the 7 car. In row 11 are the 3 car and the DeWalt Power Tools Ford. In row 12 are the Caterpillar Dodge and the America Online Chevrolet. Row 13 finds the Kodak Max Film Pontiac and the 18 car. The 14th row has the 41 car and the Hooters Ford. In row 15 are the 36 car and the 12 car. Starting the race from row 16 are the Net Zero Pontiac and the 55 car. Row 17 has the Team Rusty Dodge and the Motorcraft Ford. Starting in row 18 will be the 02 car and the Pennzoil Chevrolet. In row 19 are the 38 car and the NBC car. In row 20 are the BAM Racing Dodge and the 57 car. Back in row 21, we have the Citgo Ford and the Georgia Pacific Dodge. And rounding out the field is the 32 car.
16 car, jump out. All clear, buddy.
Still there.
number 18, now left. The 18 car is still there. Falling back. Focus on your marks, buddy. You're clear. looking left. Okay, you've got some driving to do. The leader has about 10 seconds on us. Broke into the top 10. Thank you. Number 01, it's up.